to the stage. This young lady could be seen all over the country doing big shit. Y'all seen her on Kevin Hart's Presents Next Level. Y'all seen her on Heart of the City on Comedy Central. You seen her on HBO, Russell Simmons, All Deaf Comedy. She's here every Thursday right now. Put your hands together right now for Justine. DJ out the budget because clearly I got a good playlist for you, a motherfuckers. This is not DJ worthy yet, but we're gonna get one eventually when y'all tell y'all friends to bring a friend. I got some flyers made, so if y'all got a job for all my working people, if you don't got a job, give it to the niggas on the block. You know, do niggas come to comedy shows like on the block niggas? Those niggas. Oh, he do. Like a real job and shit now. Okay, cool. So, yeah, because he was on the block. Like, we grew up on the same block. And the nigga was literally on the block. So I just, look at you now. Country Club Hills, nigga. Okay. The nigga was in Country Club Hills, nigga. God's name. Okay. But, nah, I'm glad y'all came. We're going to have a really good time. Like I said, just celebrate. This is like our third or fourth week. So it's a new room. And this is actually a banquet hall. So shout out to the atrium for letting us do it. This is a banquet hall. You can have your birthday parties. It's a big part over there. I got the lobby. So they're like, yeah, you have it in the doorway. I'm like, okay, that'll work. But they do real dope events. So if you got like a reception or a birthday party or an abortion party, like just do it. It's fun. Okay, cool. So yeah, welcome to the atrium. So this is not like a club or a bar. You know, some people, they already got their crowd coming. This is not, because it's only be open on Thursday, so we have to spread the word, be, you know, on what ground, what is it called, grassroots? Okay, there you go. That's some social work. Is this your first time here, clap? Most of the crowd, okay, I'm gonna see what Joe's gonna do again. All right, that's cool, I just want to. You two motherfuckers act like you don't hurt this shit. Nah, we're gonna have fun. That's why I host, because I like to keep my shit fresh. Any birthdays in the building before we get started? What's this, Aries season? Aries season? You know, for the Aries. Beer, 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 beer! I could definitely be somewhere fucking right now, but I am here with you. I'm here with this strong little crowd that could. We in this bitch. This is a mighty crowd, but it's good. So keep coming, keep telling people. And we're gonna get started. Damn, sweaty. I wanted to talk about something good. Okay, I ain't gonna tell nobody this. I'm gonna tell y'all this because it's like an AA meeting and that's not a lot of people here. But I don't tell a lot of people this, but I'm gonna tell you. Okay. So my mama started driving Uber. And I don't know how I feel about that, because I'm like, no, bitch, that's not what you have to do. Like, you don't have to do this. See, I think somebody was like, I'm trying to check or something. She was like, I'm just going to drive Uber for 3 months to supplement what they're taking. I'm like, I'll just help you out for 3 months. You should be driving Uber, because you're my mama. Okay, and not that nothing wrong with that, but she talks too much. So she tell everybody I'm her daughter. So she tell all these strangers, oh yeah, I don't know if you know Justineesh, that's my daughter. Watch Kevin Hart, Comedy Central, watch HBO. And they be like, damn, your daughter got hell. Your daughter got your head driving Uber too. I'm like, no, we definitely okay. Like, we can pay our bills. And she be talking, they be like, yo, tell her to come to my shop. I'm gonna do her hair. She called me like, ooh, Tanisha, this lady wanna do your hair. She'll call you. I'm like, well, I'm not going to nobody's shop. Quit telling them people you know me. Because I just don't think she should have to do that. And then today she came home, because I was like, I thought she quit. And then last week she was driving Uber. She came home today, I was like, Mom, would you stop driving Uber? She said, I didn't stop driving Uber. I'm like, thank you. She said, I'm with Lyft now. I'm like, man. She's like, I'm gonna get these 10 free rides and get my bonus. I'm like, oh, Mom, you was embarrassing me. And she really, I never told her, did you know my mama drove Uber? This my cousin. I don't tell nobody shit. Now my brother drive Uber too, I don't get no fuck. I don't get no fuck. That nigga drive Uber at 18,000 hours a day. I don't give no fuck. He the one got her on it, like crack. He the one who got her. So yeah, I don't know how I feel about that. But yeah, now she would live and shit, so I'm really mad. But that's a true story, not even a joke. Okay, this is gonna be the crowd. Oh, fuck. And then too, I'm gonna tell y'all this. I'll probably do it at the end of the show. True TV left my left tracks. They looking for new comics. I don't know if y'all seen that new series, True TV left my left tracks. It's a new comedy show. And they looking for new comics, and they been sweating me to submit a video. They want me to be on the show, but it's a storytelling comedy show. Like, I got story. That was a story right there, but I wouldn't use that on TV. I definitely can tell the world my mama got over, but I would tell you eight niggas. But so probably at the end of the show, I'm gonna do my little clip. I gotta send them like a 6-minute clip of my two jokes I'm gonna do. So I'll probably do that at the end of the night, and I'll see how y'all feel, and then. Can you record it and send it to me? Well, I gotta do it for my phone. Okay.
I got it.
Oh, thank you. So yeah, I'm gonna do that, but I'm gonna get these cameras. I'm just gonna make him do it. Cause you do my audition video while you got this camera. This was a good night for you to come. Cause I'm definitely finna run out of storage on that motherfucker, so. I don't even know what type of phone that is. That's my sad phone. See, both been sweating me, cause they give me all free phones, man, but they want you to add a line. And I do it every time for the free phone. I got like 10 lines. The fuck? Okay. Cool. I'm probably gonna find a lot of couples. Any couples in here? I see y'all. Not y'all, as y'all could be. I mean, I'm not here. I mean, I'm proud with it, you know. If that's your thing, LGBT, I'll rock out. I know those just you with your baby. Oh, y'all a couple?
We just broke up.
Oh, God's plan. Okay, cool. I'm just trying to see. And I'm gonna do. No, not y'all. They're behind y'all. Okay. Because I'm gonna do these cheating jokes. I'm gonna write break up. No, because I really want to ask couples real shit. Because, oh, hey, in the back. Okay, cool. Because, like, couples, if you've been together, like, how long y'all been together?
About 3 months.
Damn, that's right. Okay. Y'all ain't cheating yet. Okay, I just want to do that. I just really want to know, like, how long have you been together? 14? Damn! That's what's, I can't even be with a nigga for 14 days! Oh, well, I'm gonna message y'all then. Okay, I need like a 2-3 year. 2-3 year relationship. Cause I just wanted to ask, like, don't y'all want to cheat sometime? Like, don't you want to fuck somebody else? Sometime. Not every day, but like, when I say shit like that, but just as a human, like I said, it's a bit like, and that's like I say, you can be happy and faithful and monogamous and have a really good time, but I know you want to fuck somebody else sometimes. And just to like, then you go right back. I think like every 3 months you should be able to fuck somebody else. Free pass. Free pass. Semi-annual, like a Victoria's Secret sale, bitch. Like, just to, I'm gonna get my semi-annual dick. Leave me alone. Like, give you a weekend. It'd be just like the sale. That'll make shit work because I would give my guy a pass. Like, cause then you ain't got shit on me. Like, okay, cool, this your pass. This your 3 month, not a month, but like 2 days, nigga. Don't get carried away. You give a nigga an inch, you take him out. He fucking everybody. He's like, I got a date. That nigga fuck 5 bitches on his pass. No, nigga, 1 bitch per pass. You can't wait. This ain't a super coupon, nigga. he get it on it, but just because I just think that that's human nature. Like you not, it's okay for you to be attracted to more than one person, or it's okay for you to like what, like, it's too many, it's billions of people on this earth. We the only people worry about what motherfuckers fucking somebody else. Monkeys ain't out here tripping. Monkeys don't get no fuck if they monkey fuck. They out here like, fuck bitches, get monkey. We out here, we don't get no fuck. I'm gonna eat these ants off your back and we live to see another day. Like, he better just fuck the monkey. He gonna bring her over, she gonna get his ants off his back. It's us, we so involved with my emotions, and it's just sex. But a lot of people can't separate sex from emotions, and that's why I don't have a boyfriend. Because I say shit like this every show. They're like, oh, that bitch gonna for sure shit on me. Correct. But you gotta be with somebody you understand. Like, I've been with a cheater before, but we got each other. And we both were shit, but we was dope ass. We ain't shit, but we are shit. Like, we very dope and respectful. But, and it wasn't even like an open relationship. We just knew we wasn't shit. So we was like, cool, it worked. Two negatives, it goes. That was one of the best relationships I had. Shit. I was too mad when he went back to his wife. How dare you? That is some selfish shit you just did. True story. You probably come up here tonight. And that's cool too. But I have been dating this older nigga, and it's kind of scaring me because I haven't been with a nigga since I left my son's father, 2011. That's 7 years I've been single. I am fucked up. Like, I don't even know how to, like, I know how to act, but you just get so used to being by yourself, so you just do shit like you by yourself. So I've been dating this older nigga, and I like him. I haven't liked nobody since Cameron's dad, and he's just older. This nigga got a Bluetooth. I'm like, nigga, we still do that? And he be on it, like, every day. Like, you walk in, though, I'm like, oh, I cannot about that. I can walk into the comedy show, they gonna roast the fuck out of him, but he's very handsome. He got a little soft. I'm not bringing him around no comedy shows, but I like him enough to bring him around. That's how I know I like him, because I will bring him here, and I will let the comedians roast his ass, because I like this nigga. And I dare one of y'all say something, and I'm slapping the fuck out of all of y'all. I like him, he's dope as fuck, old ass. So yeah, that's been like 3 months. That's been like 3 months. And it's good too, like he ain't been on no pills or nothing. Like, I'm like, nigga, how long this gonna last? Cause he ain't on no pills or nothing, it's good, so. And I don't wanna introduce him. Ooh, I ain't bring him around nobody yet, so I'm for sure. But yeah, true story, okay. I'm doing some jokes after the comedy. I just want to make sure y'all warm. I'm just trying to warm y'all up because, like I said, I host, so I get to have fun. I get to do shit. I tell some real jokes in between. But my comics are here. We got a super dope show for y'all. And I appreciate y'all coming out. Y'all ready to laugh? Make some noise, y'all. Give me some energy. Come to the stage. His first brother is super fun. You can see him all across the country doing big shit. Put your hands together right now for Lamar Davis.
Come give it up for Just Beast, man. It's crazy, man. After all the accomplishments you make and everything. And what the fuck you got behind this curtain over here? It's a trap door to where the cocaine at? As you said, it's gonna be cocaine at this show. Y'all good, though? Man. See, you said it's gonna be drinks, cocaine, and black, and jokes, right? That's your motto. You want some cocaine. Yes. I'm in here, damn it, dressed like a Gap kid, this motherfucker. Hey, I'm gonna keep it real with y'all. I'm a black man, for real name Herman. Like, what was my parents thinking naming me that? Like, kids used to tell me, like, your name Herman, who named you that? My mom and daddy, fuck you think? That's who gave me that name. Like, I used to be scared to actually tell girls my real name when I was young. Like, I just think they would go back to their house and grammar school and be like, ugh, mama, I'm talking to Herman. They'd be like, ugh, what is that, the school janitor or something? Like, no, that's my classmate. Like, ugh, he gonna grow up to be the school janitor. I'm like, no, fuck with him. But now that I got older, I embrace my name. I go for job applications to credit cards. I put Herman at the top. and I chest braced white. Herman winning now. Herman getting nigga job, the credit, all that. Thank you. Thank you for naming Herman now. You know what? I want to talk about something that like is an issue. I don't know if it's in every community, black community, whatever. It's just an issue. Like, some women get so independent in life, and they meet a guy, they, you know, be a single mother, he come in the picture, he come help her. Why would it be a problem when he say something to your child? If he's paying the mortgage, you're paying half the bills. I feel like he got a right to say something. I ain't saying beat your child, but just saying sit your little ass down somewhere, goddammit. You know what I'm saying? Shit, I need a break. Now why is it a problem? I'm saying something. I'm stepping up to the plate. You know what I'm saying? Like I did that in my relationship. I stood up to the plate. She had a fucking problem about it. So I said, you and your daughter, y'all get the fuck out then. Shit, I ain't got time for this shit. Already when I moved in, she was mad at the goddamn cereal I eat. She won't name brand shit. Time I go up there. Come on, you got cereal? Yeah, I got cereal, Dad. She pulled the shit down. It's Flakes and Frosty. She like, where the fuck Tony the Titan? I said, shit, he on the run, okay? Nigga got a warrant out for his arrest. They looking for his ass in child support. Like, he's trying to find your damn daddy, okay? They put a fucking patent down here. This nigga filled in for the photo shoot. This is the only thing they can find. Shit. Go up there, go pull some more shit down. She pulled down Crunchin' Berry. Daddy, where Captain Crunch it? The nigga on the cruise. I don't know shit. Eat this shit. And I love that generic ass cereal. Cause you can leave that shit right there and come back and you can go sell dope, do whatever the fuck, and that cereal will still be hard. Shit can still taste fresh. Hey, let me talk to y'all for a minute. Have anybody here ever counted 100 chicken wings before leaving the Sharks or JJ's? No, we ain't. Well, let us go to McDonald's and your barbecue sauce not that bad. You're gonna go off on them fucking people about your barbecue sauce for these 20 nuggets. And they making 8, 25, whatever they making, you giving them hell. These fucking Arabs making all this money. Go order 50 wings, right? Pitch it to the pan. The wings in there, the little tips, they busting out the aluminum foil. The wing stuff like they in the... The wing stuff like they in the bullpen at the Cook County Jail. They overcrowded in this pen. Now go order a honey. The pen is a little bit longer, but these wings laid out like they on vacation. There's too much room in this pen to be a honey. So I did a show at the lounge. So the cook, he came out the back like, man, look, nigga, that shit was funny than a motherfucking joke. Straight up. He was like, you know what? It don't be a hundred in that pen. You right, nigga. I said, you motherfucker, I knew it. Y'all better start doing what I'm gonna do. Go in there and order 5 pans of 20 wings and take 5 motherfuckers with you. And we all gonna count these wings out. Get our money's worth. Straight up. Cause do you remember when, do y'all remember when 3 wings was for $1? I feel like that was an experiment. Once they saw we eat the shit out the wings, they say, go up. Harold's chicken, 4 wings, $8. Goddamn, for 4 wings? But the shit even go all the way back to slavery. When they give us the parts of the pea that they didn't want. They sat around and watched us eat it and said, you know what? Them chickens, put a price tag on that shit. Right up. Why only black people and white people is the only race that eat peppy tacos? Mexicans cook that shit, but they don't eat. They been having a grill eating peppy tacos serving to us, but ask the Mexicans to eat peppy tacos. You know you don't tell? No. No, senor, I know you eat peppy tacos. You don't eat no fucking peppy. That's not even real Mexican food. So I was fucked up when they told me that, they said it's not real Mexican food. I said, nigga, ain't this a tortilla shell with shit? That's like me telling you, you gonna order a bacon cheeseburger. That's not a real bacon. Nigga, this bacon, this cheese, and it's a burger on this motherfucker. Fuck what you talking about. I made it my way. It's a bacon cheeseburger. And two, don't eat no Chinese food if that shit next to an animal hospital or a pet shop or none of that shit. But you know Miss Wong been sitting out front watching every little hurt animal come through that motherfucker. Ooh! Cujo look fucked up. Bring Cujo around back. We make orange chicken. Orange chicken coming up. We don't know if that good that shit. They probably don't eat that shit too. For real. Anybody work with a bunch of Mexicans? Besides me? I'm sorry about that stereotype. We always talking about they the hottest working nigga. That's a lie. Them motherfuckers worked their ass off my job for 6 months. Soon as they probation over, they some snitching motherfuckers. They don't do nothing but tail, eat tortilla shells, and hot peppers. You little motherfuckers. They be telling on me, I be like Janko out there. Like, soon they tell me, I'm like, I just gotta keep working. I turn around one day, I try to snitch on them. The owner gonna tell them, you know that nigga snitching on y'all. Say, ain't this a bitch? Y'all come could break me when they tell on me. Like, I gotta work through all this shit. But that's my time, y'all. My name Lamar Davis. Y'all enjoy the rest of y'all night. God bless you.
Thank you, Lamar Davis, y'all. Get it up. He got that, ooh, I got that black jacket in the crib. Rainbow sell them. He got that from Rainbow Men's. I didn't know they had a men's collection. That's dope. But no, I literally just bought a black jacket from Rainbow. And, I almost wore it tonight, but I wore my hoodie instead, but that's what's up. Ooh, I love Rainbow. Like, I don't care how much money I get, I'm never gonna stop shopping at Rainbow. I don't give a fuck. I'm never gonna stop. And they don't even give a fuck about Rainbow. Your zipper be broke before you walk out that bitch. You keep going back. Ooh, that clothes ain't shit. That disposed. We gotta wear Rainbow clothes like a condom. One time, throw it in the garbage, bitch. Cause that's it. Don't you wash shit from Rainbow. It's a whole nother shirt. But it be cute. It's cute. Rainbow is, I gotta do something tonight and I got $8. Let me go kill these bitches real quick. You can ball out of Rainbow. You want Rainbow with $30. You got jeans, top, jewelry, pants, bra, pickle puppy, a nigga. You get so much. And you still got change left. I'll be fucking Rainbow up. But I hate when people see me in Rainbow. Like, people like, ain't you that comedian? I'm like, nope. Nope, wrong bitch. Let me shop in peace and be broke in peace. I hate when people see me. And I be in there raggedy as fuck, scarf on. You don't give a fuck when you go to Rainbow. You be having on pajamas, a bonnet. You look like you shop at Rainbow. You gotta get in the mood to shop at Rainbow. Like, yeah, let me just stank and just go in this store. Get my life together. True shit. All right, we gonna keep it looking. Everybody act like they ain't shopping at Rainbow. I ain't the only bitch keeping them open. I was gonna protest. Them motherfuckers. Because Docs was like a little bit better than Rainbow. Docs kept bitches out of Rainbow. So he was like, oh, y'all ain't that. I ain't like Rainbow, bitch. Nah, I'm in Docs hope. But Docs closed, I went right to Rainbow. Like, I have arrived. And that's good too. And then they all. Well, one day I shop somewhere else. I don't know where though. Cause I don't know who that, like, I'm not paying a lot of money for no clothes. I don't give no fuck. I'm so fuck all that. I'll be mad as fuck. And it's crazy cause I spend like $40 on some food quick. But let a shirt be $22. I'd be like, $22? Oh no, let me put that back. $22? Bitch just left Hooters, tap $600. Oh, true story. Okay. This is actual, y'all congrats. So I'm really being open with y'all. Like, and I know I'm finna be like, I'm finna have like a lot of money, but I'm gonna be fucking Rainbow up. They gonna hate me. I'm gonna buy my own Rainbow. I ain't gonna shop at Boys. I'm just gonna buy a Rainbow. It's gonna be my Rainbow, and I'll be my own personal store. All right, cool. Oh, I better look skinny as fuck on this. I ain't stuck my stomach in this whole time. You gotta tell me, go zoom in or something. Okay, come to the stage. Ooh, don't you ever motherfucker post your picture, bitch. Don't you ever post, and you tag me too, bitch, I'll kill you. Don't you ever tag me in some shit. You know my stomach's sticking the fuck out. I wasn't looking. Oh, I be so mad at people. That's just disrespectful. You don't know who on my page looking at me. Cause all my bitches be good. All the ones I post, they be raw. And then you go into your tag bitches, you like, what the fuck is these bitches? Who took it? Where they take it? That should be from 3 years ago. This shit set up here for 3 years, bitch. We not friends no more on Facebook or real life, huh? You don't give a fuck Everybody else cross-eyed. He was like, oh no, that's good. You be cute as fuck. Oh yeah, that's good. Everybody else looking fucked up. You look dead at yourself. Oh no, that's cool. Keep that. Everybody blurry assholes. Slide right. Send it to me. That picture don't be shit. You just be shining. Okay. Oh, y'all so fun. All right, we're gonna keep it rolling. Coming to the stage next, this is my boy, funny as fuck. And like I said, we got, these are my guests. These comics fell through off the strength. The people that were booked, they coming up. But these are just extra credit comics, and they rock with me, so y'all getting a little bonus comedy. I hope this is okay with y'all. Y'all want some more makes some noise? Keep that right there, y'all want some more. Ty, all y'all, let's get it.
Cut that shit. Y'all make some noise one time for these. One time, make some noise for them. I know what some of y'all thinking. What size is this shirt? Don't worry about it. It's my size. Fit me real good. It's the only one on the hanger. What God has for you is for you. Believe that. Found out that I was small. Recently found out I was small. Thought I was gonna get bigger than this. Never hit my growth spurt. Found out I was small when I started trying to date older women. Asked this older girl out. I'm like, you wanna get something to eat? You a little hungry? She's like, oh, you're so cute. You're just like a little man baby. I'm like, bitch, what? Two words. I'm a man, baby. Okay. Need you learn how to enunciate your words properly. But you fucked up. You know, I'm trying to do romantic shit. Took this one girl out. We went downtown to this nice little restaurant. Real nice. They had little hostess and everything. They asking all the couples that come up like, would you like a booth or a seat? Would you like a booth or a seat? You know, booth or a seat. So I get up there to do like, you want a booth or seat? I'm like, nigga, what? A booth or seat? I got a booster seat for your ass. So after I got the booster seat, we was chilling. Dinner was nice. Dinner was really nice. Fuck you, I'm glad you're here. Some high chairs. Some high chairs. But yeah, man. Like I said, new year, new me. Trying to do different stuff. Found out I was small too. Shopping clothes. Was at the store the other day. Seen this nice little sweater. Didn't have a tag on it. Got to the register, the cashier. She wanted to do a damn price check right there in front of everybody and shit. She looking at the chart like, oh, this ain't no tag. She's like, can I get a price check for the boys department? I'm like, this is the grown man sweater. That is not a boy's size. She tripping out. I'm not going to the man's department. Hell in the man's section. Fuck y'all. That's why I do my shower online. It's like, oh, no, you're just spilling that joke a little too high. I'm feeling. But it's fucked up, man. I'm trying to do some dating stuff. I haven't been dating. I stopped dating ratchet girls. I completely alleviated that from my diet. I stopped dating ratchet women. Y'all can clap for that. I appreciate it. Appreciate that. I'm trying to better myself, you know. But the one thing I don't like about ratchet girls, they try to act like they're not ratchet. But the minute they start talking, that's when you know they're ratchet. Like I'm out with this one girl. I'm trying to do something different with her. I took a wine tasting, you know. So I asked her, I'm like, have you ever been wine tasting before? She like, oh yeah, I used to go all the time when I was a little girl. I'm like, how the fuck did you go when I was a little girl? Like, can you explain this wine tasting a little bit to me? She like, oh yeah, it was on some Sundays with my grandma. And it was real nice. It was a spoken word artist. They were serving bread and wine. People were singing. I'm like, you talking about church? Bitch, I was communion. Okay, let me get that check. It's time to go. Thank you, Tinder. Okay. Should've swiped love. Alright. You know, that but how many people got health insurance? I mean, life insurance, not health insurance. Life insurance? How many people got life insurance? Make sure. Okay, four people care about their life. It's only yours. It's not nobody else's. But I just, like I said, I'm doing some adult shit now. Just recently got life insurance. Was doing a little research. Did y'all know that you could like take a loan out on your life insurance policy? Did you know that? If it's all right, the whole life, right. See, this is new to me. I didn't know. I'm thinking like, you know, that could be good or bad, depending on, you know, what's going on in your life, you know. And I'm thinking like, you know, times get hard, you down there at State Farm, you get to contemplate, you know, like, when are We ain't gotta have a nun's funeral, dog. Let me get a little bit of this right now. I'm just gonna take some of this with me. I'll be back next week, put something on it. Come back in again, like, you know what? We ain't gotta have a casket. I ain't gonna be there nowhere. We cremate the body, right? I ain't gonna be there. I mean, I don't need a casket. I mean, don't even need a funeral. I mean, we can Facebook live the whole thing from mama house. She got a nice little basement. Nigga be down this last 100, like, shit, that new iPhone coming out. Let me get that little 100 up out of there. Fuck yeah, I'm working on that one. Alright, then my last one, I'm gonna go. I feel like I can work my little 10 cents off tonight. But anybody hang out with, like, the grandparents, got elderly people they kicking with? Anybody? Fuck your grandma? Okay, she went shit. Oh, okay, yeah, okay, that's cool. But I hang out with my grandma, we got a real dope relationship. If anybody know anything about elderly people, they like real routine. Like, my grandma, she sit at home all day watching TV shows. Her TVs go off, she watch the news. The news go off, she back watching her TV shows. So one day I'm over there kicking it with my grandma. I'm a little thirsty. I go into the refrigerator, get something to drink. She got typical grandma shit, Coke Zero, prune juice, some flat ass 7-Up. You know, shit don't nobody really drink. But it's your grandma, you know. So I get the 7-Up. Now, I'm a little thirsty, I'm gonna put a little ice in it to make it cool. So I look in the freezer to get some ice. Now, I noticed that my grandma ain't got no ice in her freezer. No ice trays, no nothing. So I look at her, I'm like, I yell at her, I'm like, grandma, you know you ain't got no ice in here? She like, baby, ain't you been watching the news? I'm like, the news, what? She's like, the ice has been attacking people. I'm like, grandma. You think it's a minute? Think it's gonna catch on? Can I get a minute to catch there? Let me give it a minute. All right, I think that was it. I'm telling y'all, y'all get ready.
Come on, come on, cut it, DJ. All right, cut it, DJ. Cool, cut it. Yeah. Okay. Let's talk about the real DJ. This shit ain't working. But give it up for Kyle again, one more time. Look out, yeah. He's so cute. He looked like a little baby Jamie Foxx. Like, honey, I shrunk to Jamie. Like, he's so cute. Okay. I'm gonna run it. Okay, your closes are in the building, so I'm just gonna run the comics 5 minutes for the next two. Okay. Y'all know how much time. All right, come to the stage. Funny as fuck. This is my boy, y'all. He's all the way from Milwaukee. And he's definitely been doing his thing all over the country. He came here tonight to rock out with us. Y'all put your hands together right now for Anthony Washington, y'all. Let him hear his clap real quick.
Hey, what
the fuck? I got the music in my head. I'm like walking and shit like I'm coming up to get blessed and shit. I'm sorry, Pastor. You can bless me. I know I sin. I smell like loud and shit. That's what I need to be delivered from. God damn it. What's up, Chantel? Fuck it. I'm not coming to some music, but fuck it. We're going to do this like we at Family Dollar, I guess. Shit. I ain't lying. I love this city. Ain't right. I came to this motherfucker and I said, I ain't leaving. This city dangerous, y'all. Seriously, y'all city dangerous and exciting. At the same time, that's why I had to put on this suit, go look for the party. So the North Side fooling them motherfuckers till they check my credit. They better get your ass back to the South Side. I ain't gonna lie, I went and I found this apartment on Saturday 1st and I pulled up and I went in that motherfucker and dude opened the door and a roach ran across the front of the door. We both stood there. He played like he didn't see that motherfucker. It's like, you see that roach, motherfucker. How many of y'all grew up with roaches? Damn, you motherfuckers that bougie? Y'all some black people that ain't never grew up with roaches? Look at us. We done overcame, huh? So we got rid of the roaches. We good now. I ain't gonna lie. That shit was fucking me up. Because I remember, I'm ghetto. I'm Paul. You know what I mean? I grew up, huh? Hey, I'm good now, but if you ain't never grown up poor, I grew up in the 80s, and you had to deal with roaches and welfare. And I ain't gonna lie, Nah, you ain't experienced. How many of y'all have experienced where you went out, left a bag of cookies over, your favorite bag, and you came home and there was a roach sitting on that cookie that you wanted to eat? You know what I'm talking about. People that experience roaches know, goddamn. That roach sit there like, motherfucker, you ain't gonna eat the rest of these motherfuckers. How many of y'all ever blown out roaches in a microwave? But you fool. How many of y'all older? Like, I'm 48. Clap your hands if you're over 40. Yeah, we survived, didn't we? But they ain't tell you your body was gonna start fucking with you. I went to the doctor, they got health insurance. Young people, they ain't got health insurance. When you get older, you get health insurance. You go tell the doctor something wrong. Motherfucking doctor told me some shit I didn't know happened to motherfuckers when we get old. He said, I said, look, when I go eat at White Castle, my ass lose, it's motherfucking mine. You get to go tell the doctor shit like that. You eat too much fucking White Castle, you can go to the doctor. I'm like, look, this asshole ain't working right. It's like, nigga, you got irritable bowel syndrome, nigga. I ain't gonna lie, y'all food is addictive here, nigga. Like, I was amazed because y'all got food that blow me away because I ain't never heard of the shit that y'all do to food here. Like, I came here and I found out that y'all fry pickles. Yeah, that's what I said. That had to be the first hot nigga in the world to come home and fry a pickle, nigga. Somebody thought of that shit. They thought that was the shit. Came home, didn't have no sugar water no more and said, I got pickles. No meat, no bread, and fire. And fried a pickle. And y'all eating that shit like every day here. I know shit about, the one thing I know about is the Polish sausages. Y'all Polish sausages is shit. You get hooked on Polish sausages here. I went down to Roosevelt and saw it for myself. 1,000 niggas waiting outside for a fucking Polish sausage in February. No shoes on, no socks, no gloves. Just for a poke sausage. I got mine, I got her. I ain't shitted in 3 years. So I had to go to the doctor. Okay, I'm gonna leave y'all with this because, you know, we running and I'm having fun. So basically, I'm gonna leave y'all with this. I'm 48. I ain't got kids, I ain't got no wife. I'm trying to go raw now. Seriously, I'm trying to find a bitch I can go raw with. You niggas laughing. That's 17% kicking your ass right now, though. I ain't gonna lie, I want kids. I want to go raw, nigga. That's the shit. I did it one time. 83, I'll never forget. Fuck y'all up on that one. Like, damn, bitch, I want to eat one shit. 1983, nigga. I never forget that shit. I tipped my dick in that motherfucker, boy. All I thought about was death. Cause that was when Magic came out. You know what I mean? Scared the shit out of motherfuckers. Motherfuckers forgot about AIDS. AIDS still around, motherfucker. These motherfuckers out here coughing and shit, talking about they on a diet. Y'all done forgot about AIDS. Bitch on the AIDS diet. Bitch ain't. Oh, diet plan. Okay, so this is it. I'm gonna leave y'all with this because this is a public service announcement. Because like I said, I'm trying to find a wife. And I grew up in the era where girls wore their natural scalp to school. So you bitches ain't seen y'all scalps in years, huh? Seriously, I grew up in that era, nigga. Ain't one no weed back then in the 80s, nigga. So nigga came to the motherfucking school looking like a slave, bitch. Bitch looked like a slave, but she said, "Do you like me, check, yes or no?" I said, "Yes, bitch." Like a slave, but you got some ass on you, goddamn. So I'm gonna say this to some of the niggas, you know, do me a favor, because I ain't gonna lie, women, don't take this the wrong way, goddamn, because you look beautiful, y'all look beautiful in the motherfucker. But ain't no way in hell I'm gonna say I do without seeing what the fuck that scalp look like. You niggas going out of aisle and ain't, you gonna be disappointed one day, goddamn. Just take that motherfucker off, look like Kermit the Frog on your ass, nigga. You be like, dang, I need Viagra. Okay, this is the last one. I'm done. I'm having fun. She let me go. So here's what I'm gonna tell y'all. This is my joke that I told 22 years ago when I first started doing comedy. I went to jail for doing stupid shit. And in jail, I learned how to tell jokes because a skinny nigga like me, nigga, you gotta keep them niggas laughing. Nigga can't fuck you if you laughing, nigga. Never seen a nigga hard laughing at the same time, nigga. That shit before. So basically, here's a joke I told, first joke I ever told at church, and they kicked me out. I started doing comedy. It's a priest and a nun riding on a camel in the middle of the desert, just ride this motherfucker. Bam, bam, camel dies, middle of the desert. Priest looks at the nun, says, "Oh my God, we're gonna die out here." She says, "Oh my gosh, if we're gonna die out here, I just need one thing to happen." He says, "What is it?" She says, "I need to see what a man's body looks like." He says, "Oh my sister, I will oblige if you let me see what a woman's body look like." So they make the agreement, and there it is. She rips off her blouse, rips off her skirt, and bam, pussy titties. Ah, beautiful, he was like, "Oh my gosh." She says, "It's my turn. What does the dick look like?" So he rips off his pants, and there it is, the dick sticking strong and holy. So she says, "My father, what does it do when it's sticking out like that?" He looks at her and he says, "My sister, if I stick it in you, it will bring life into this world more abundantly." So she looks at the father and says, "Well, why don't you stick it in this goddamn camel and bring his ass back to life so we can get the fuck out of here then?" That's my time, y'all. Peace out. Shout out.
Look good, all right. Some of y'all not smiling, haven't smiled much of the night. I'm not sure what's going on with that, but we got a couple more comics to work through that smile. If you're smiling on the inside, let it out. Let that bitch out. Ain't nobody here with us. Shit. I know who y'all thought was coming. Sex entertainment? No, bitch, that's it. There's about to be a few more niggas coming up that y'all don't know, so don't. This is the best you're gonna get. Okay, coming to the stage, very funny brother. He popped in, he was here earlier than me, shit. So he's definitely gonna go up. He's not from Chicago, and he moved to Chicago. He'll tell you more about that. Funny as fuck, put your hands together for my boy. Lionel Price, y'all. Lionel Price.
Yeah.
Dog in there just barking like. I'm like, "Nigga, do you know where you at?" And then you're on the wrong side of town, G. Like, I don't know about y'all, but I don't trust Chinese food. Not just because how it looks sometimes, just because of the names they got. Like, think about the names, y'all. Like, Mongolian beef. What that sound like? That sound like a smart nigga brain, don't it, G? Like, "We ate the Mongolian part of his brain. They got minerals, protein, orange chicken. The chicken was still orange. orange, G. It wasn't even cooked all the way, G. Come on, y'all. Think about it, man. All right, y'all ever been in a like a ratchet Chinese restaurant? That'd be really awkward, G. Y'all ever been in one? Like, I went in one in Atlanta one time, and it was like a black Chinese chicken there. And like, you know, I went in there and like, I felt like she was baking my ass while she was taking my order and shit, G. Like, cause I walked in there, she's like, "Welcome to Black China. I am horny." I was like, "You horny?" She's like, "No, my name's Horny." I'm like, "Okay." She's like, "What would you like?" I was like, "Man, let me get a egg foo young and a orange chicken." One orange chicken, one egg foo young for a broke boy. Look like he lives with his mama. This shit sounded so much better in my head, G. I love the spot though, so I grabbed the menu and shit. It's called Black China. And I want someone to order from Horny. Oh, Horny is going to. Hello, what would you like?
Egg roll. And let me get that nasty looking shit.
What egg roll? One Mongolian beef. Four strong independent sister. Real weave. Oh no. Baby daddy outside. Cancel order.
Shrimp fried mice.
Large order for shrimp fried mice. For a big black man. Invisible army camouflage. $13.95. What would you like?
Egg roll and chicken food.
Give my K-Star homie egg roll. Just got out 2 weeks ago. On parole for stabbing a nigga.
Oh no, y'all. Okay, one more order. Should I take one more order? Oh no. Let me see.
Oh God, to my God. Oh my God. What would you like? What would you like? Sister!
Shrimp fried mice.
Let me get that nasty looking shit. Mongolian beef, Johnny. Mongolian beef. Get it for sister. Hurry up. Tia Tamara. Show got canceled 2 weeks ago. They never coming back on air. $13.95.
Fuck it. We gonna take another order. This shit funny. I ain't got no more written shit.
Who's gonna die? I am horny. Who's gonna die? I am horny. What would you like?
I would like
you. Oh.
Strong independent black woman. Would you give me some pussy? How y'all been, Lionel Price? Y'all been great.
Lionel Price, stupid ass. Give it up for all me, stupid, stupid, stupid. You know, come on, y'all participated, that was dope. Okay, I got a feature act for tonight. So we got two more comments and then we, gonna break out the cocaine. Okay, so, who still do cocaine? Clap. Y'all so shy. I hate niggas be shy. Motherfuckers will do anything, but if they do cocaine. Okay. yeah, no, I don't do cocaine yet. But I be at the parties with these niggas. Like, I be in Hollywood. These niggas got the cocaine on them. That's how I know I'm going places, bitch. I ain't leveling up. They got the cocaine on them, homie. It's already on them. Then I come back home, and then my buddy put out some weed. I be like, weed? Nigga, don't touch me, you peasant. Get the fuck off of me. You my poor. We on cocaine level now, bitch. Get your drugs up, you wanna fuck with me. This light ain't shining on nobody. I don't know, I got it up here, but it's just dumb. We'll fix it. This is like a rehearsal show. The next show, the real show next week. Thank you for coming to practice in this motherfucker. Okay. Come to the stage. This is my boy. I'm so excited for him to be here because he's always so busy. I'm always so busy, so we never really get to see each other work because we never have shows together. But he's here tonight, rocking out for me. Y'all can see this nigga all over the country. Y'all see him on TV. Funny as fuck. Put your hands together for Jeremiah Frazier. Let me hear y'all clapping up that way.
Microphone in my own. Which number? Where am I? And this me, right here?
What you need,
loud or? Yeah, just look. I do this at church. Excuse me. Put the light on me. I can't see in the dark. Put the light on me. Oh, Nisha gotta tell you what to do, nigga? What the? Okay, there we go. That's what I'm looking for. There we go. That's another vowel. Y'all learn. All right, clap for me again, please. Thank you. I gotta get this house in order. You niggas are so out of order. I just came here from Chatham. You can take a break, nigga, because you've been cameraing all night. He don't need to record me, do he? Is this? Go ahead and turn it off, man. Nisha ain't paid for that. Take a break, nigga. This your break time. You get the last for me. You can't put this on film. I ain't even put it on my DVD yet. Pause. Just pause. Put it on. Ain't nobody gonna take your camera and leave it right there. And then you go. Ain't enough niggas in here to steal, nigga. She don't know who got it. $20 after 10, player. $20 after 10. This nigga asking questions now. Nobody told me that. Now the seat's gonna get the crowd first. Make sure you're ready. Y'all get this nigga a hand. You know what you're doing, man. Hey, this nigga looks like a professional pervert. He just. Gonna aim the camera right at me, nigga, like an AK. Look at him. This nigga's hilarious. You see, it's hilarious. Alright, I wrote a song called Mind Your Business. It's got over 250,000 views going all over the world. That's what people need to do nowadays. I'm gonna hit this before I leave. Hey, player, nice of y'all to come in. Did y'all just get here? Cool, because I didn't see you before. Nice little chain, nice little cost shirt. Glad you got your taxes. You came in here. She knows it. She like, yes. And when the money runs out, so am I. So am I. All right, tell everybody real quick, mind your business. Come on, get with me on this one. Here we go. This one about Kells too. Famo in the building. You gonna get down on one knee for me, nigga? No, please stand up and record. This is gay.
wrong with this nigga, bitch? I'm not. This nigga is all into me. Nigga trying to get under the suit, nigga. Nigga, what kind of blue is that, nigga? This is gonna look good on this little boom camera. Yeah, I'm ready, baby. I've been waiting on you to press play. Shout out to Long John's in the back. That nigga's mad at me. Too bad he walked here too. Here we go, everybody, make some noise up in here. Tell somebody mind your business. Kels told him like this. Hey. Y'all gotta bounce with it. Y'all ready? Let me tell you what R. Kelly told the little girl. Let me tell you something. First of all, hold on 1 second, because this got to be right. This nigga that's recording this. Everybody get your cameras out. Y'all can record too. Put this on Instagram. Follow me, Jeremiah Funny. Facebook, all this stuff. All right? We're going to do this the right way, because you niggas too relaxed. Now, I done gave y'all 40 minutes of jokes, and you was supposed to have 20. All right? So y'all do me a favor and get with this. This light-skinned nigga with the beard. No, nigga, just leave that whole outfit where you got it from, nigga. No, you want to be a part of the show, nigga. Let's go ahead and do it. I'm trying to get the next comedian up, but this nigga, no, nigga, this nigga wore a whole Paco suit and think he's gonna talk to me. Nigga, nobody wear Mecca no more. No, nigga, no, you wear black like you singing in the choir. Nigga, I'm from the church. You ain't supposed to have on the choir uniform tonight, nigga. Tonight, I bet she don't go home with you. Nigga just embarrassed himself. But there is a gas station down the street, nigga. I'm more than ready. This nigga got me. This nigga roast you outside too, nigga. Don't walk me to my car. Here we go. One more time. This nigga just. This is the real deal. Here we go. Tell you niggas something before I go. Yeah, sit down. I'm You niggas don't even know what this is tonight. Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, Calvin is after me. This is it, and I just want to say this because, you know, you guys got some very special people in the house tonight. Just Niche is extraordinary. Me, myself, and I, thank you. Thank you. Y'all might not know I was awarded the best comedian in Chatham. Chatham got a lot of blocks, forget y'all. And tonight I usually sell my DVDs and my t-shirts, but God is taking me to another level. Tonight I'm selling my car. All right, I'm leaving y'all. I'm Jeremiah Frazier. Thank you for having me. Next time y'all see me, y'all make some more noise. Jeremiah Funnios.
Give it up for Jeremiah for doing a motherfucking Netflix special in this motherfucker. God damn, nigga. You got one more comic after you. And he did all both of that time, so this last comic, 5, 7, 10, however much you feel like, because Jeremiah did both of y'all time with his suit. Y'all do gotta be cold in the building though, like be cold is in this bitch. He did drive down to this bitch, so if y'all, I mean, because he's here, and just because he came back, we love him though. Y'all seen him on everything, BET, HBO. He just dropped in on me. He gonna do a few quick minutes, y'all. Give it up right now for Be Cold, y'all.
What's up, y'all? Hey, real quick. Y'all good? Up there in the balcony, y'all good in the balcony up there? Y'all chilling, that's what I'm talking about. Y'all ready to go home? I can see it. Y'all looking at me like they was looking at Prince at the end of Purple Rain, just staring at the motherfucker. But I ain't gonna be up here too much longer, shit. I got another show I gotta do in May, so I'm gonna get the fuck up out of here. But everybody looking good though, man. Southside of the building, Southside? Goddamn right, I need to ride home, just letting y'all know. I know who to talk to about that ride, shit. I'm from the Wild Hunters. Y'all heard of the Wild Hunters? That's one from Wild Wild. When you hit Wild Wild, that's Wild Wild. Goddamn right, shit. But I made a little money and moved to the suburbs. Now I'm in the Mal Mal Hunters. Mal Mal, we got lawn care, nigga. That's how we game bang. Trash pick up, fool. You know, real good shit. But nah, man, give it up for Just Niche, man, getting this room started. Best advertisement is word of mouth. Tell people, everybody in here, bring back 5 friends next week. Pack this bitch out. 5 of them. Let's move it to the big room. Everybody bring back 5 friends, all right? 5 friends, just spread the word. If you don't have any friends, just go home, look yourself in the mirror, say, go back. You had a good time. I see it in your face. Of course they think you're cute. I think you're cute. It's all good, though. Summertime, y'all ready for this? Be good. Shit, 70 degrees. Give it up. Shit, Chicago, 70 degrees. You know what I'm saying? We don't get that in Chicago a lot, do we? You know what I'm saying? So, you know, you better be thankful for this good weather. And we ain't got nobody to give that credit to but the man. You know the man. We got to get at the straight-up Barack Obama who did all this. You know the government control the weather. Barack walked out of the White House with one of them devices. I'ma hook Chi-Town up one day. Shit, cause the motherfucking Mother Nature is acting like a baby mama now, ain't she? That's baby mama nature. Be acting just like a baby mama and shit. Don't wanna let a nigga see her son. Let me see my son, bitch. Get it, the real son, nigga. All right, man, y'all tired as hell. Y'all go home, get some rest, relax. I ain't gonna hold y'all, you know. But what's up, Cameron dude? You gonna be here next week? Cool, man. Hey, I need a taping. I do, man. I'm trying to film my Netflix special. Cause next time y'all Netflix and chill, I want y'all to Netflix. I want to be in that threesome. I'm gonna do a threesome. Y'all just cut on me on Netflix and I'm with y'all. Shit. Y'all know Netflix and chill. That's the shit, ain't it? That ain't nothing but fucking. That's it. If you think you're going to watch a movie, ladies, foreplay is scrolling looking for a movie. You fucking right before the movie come on. You fucking why the rings, the low ring going. You fucking doing that time. That's all good though. Summertime coming up. It ain't Netflix and chill. That's some wintertime shit. I got a summertime thing now. Fuck Netflix and chill. I got a fire stick and dick. That's what that is. Come on, girl. Come get some of this fire stick and dick. When she come up, I'm like, I'm just playing, I ain't got no fire stick. But I got that. The summertime is coming. Ladies ready to kick it in the summertime, ain't you? Y'all been cooped up in the house of niggas all winter. Niggas ain't doing shit. Niggas don't want to do shit in the summertime. That's why women don't want to be with men in the summertime, do you? Because all men want to do is stay in the house and fuck. That's all you want to do all year round. You're like, I want to go to the zoo. Women like exhibits. Don't women, y'all like shit like exhibits, plays, and museums and shit. Men don't want to do shit. We ain't got no air conditioning. We just want to fuck. Pull out that bullshit rotating fan. Same fan you dry your clothes on too. Yeah. Move them damn socks so I can feel it. Goddamn right, summertime, cause you know summertime, that's when women break up with niggas right on Memorial Day, don't they? Cause they know summertime coming. Fellas, we never see it coming either. We be always caught by surprise. Look, they already hit a plane. You know I'm breaking that nigga on Memorial Day. We be in the backyard barbecuing and playing with her kids and shit. She come on the back porch, fuck your whole world up. After you flip them ribs, pack your shit. What? What'd you say? You heard me, slow turn that meat and get the fuck out. Tomorrow's June. Cause women don't want no man in the summertime. In Chicago, we only get 3 months of good weather, that's it. Women wanna do what the fuck they wanna do. Hang out with the girlfriends, go to outdoor picnics, ride on the back of other guys' motorcycles. Oh, y'all low down in the summertime, walk around all summer in them naked clothes. Panties with pockets on them. Panties with pockets, that ain't no goddamn outfit. Don't call your ass none of the summer. Nan summer you get a phone call, fellas. Nan summer. Call your ass after Labor Day when it start getting cold again. Yeah, huh? Look at them talking all that shit. Right after Labor Day. All you hear, all they be like, you wanna rent some movies? Like, nah, girl, I saw that in July by my goddamn self. That was a summer blockbuster. I saw Black Panther 3 times. Alone. All right, man, but yeah, definitely, man. We gotta come back, man. Let's do this. Anybody on Instagram? Y'all on Instagram? Please join me on Instagram. You know I'm old. I say join me on Instagram. I'm an old motherfucker. Join me. I don't want you to follow. God damn it, I'm too old to be followed. Join me so I can see your ass right here. I don't want nobody behind me. I'm too old for that shit. Fuck around with blood pressure up, goddammit. Join me on Instagram. My name is B Cole Comedian. B Cole Comedian on Instagram. Cause this the thing, and this is real shit, because it's a lot of social medians out there. When I say social medians, it's comedians who put videos out on the internet and they get like millions of followers and shit, but all they do their best is on that video. And then when you see them on a live show like this, they can't give you 10 minutes because they popular. It's a popularity contest. Let me tell you something. Sometimes the talent doesn't match the popularity, okay? But I got the talent. I don't have the fucking followers. So I need Instagram so motherfuckers can hear my name again. You know what I'm saying? So if you got an Instagram, please pull your phone out and please follow me, B Cole. Let's get my Instagram followers up so y'all can see me do something. Because when Hollywood look at that shit, they don't look at the talent. They don't click on the video. They say how many followers. Yeah, this nigga ain't got shit but 600 fucking them, you know? So they going for the people who got 30,000, 20,000, you know, stuff like that. So I need to get my game up on the Instagram. Cool? That's why y'all ain't heard from the nigga. I ain't been good. Thank you. I need that on some real shit. But I appreciate y'all, man. Next week, Niche, you got the Dream Team next week. Dream Team?
Dream Team is the 26th. Next week, I got Joe Blunt.
I still come to get down with dog. Joe Blunt. Yeah, put me down. Joe Blunt, funny as hell.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I mean, like Chicago, we gotta support each other, man. That's what we gotta do. You know, I'm April 29th. I'm flying out to LA to do a showcase for Saturday Night Live. You know what I'm saying? Kenan Thompson. So I'm going out there to do a showcase for that April 29th. So man, wish me the best of luck, the whole night and everything. You know, it's a lot of stuff going on. Just Google. Love, thank you. Y'all be cool, don't be cold, peace.
Be cold, y'all. Thank you for slamming. Get up with me, cold, y'all. He just slid out on the strength. On the strength with an F. Damn, y'all got so much comedy tonight. But support everybody. Follow me on Instagram too. I post which comments we have every week on the flyer. It's a box of flyers in the lobby, y'all. If y'all got jobs, Just grab a couple flyers, give to your coworkers, even if you don't got jobs. I keep looking at you like you ain't working. I know you're working now. you see, that was just... Okay. I'm from the block, right? From the block, I keep... So just grab a couple flyers, tell people about the show. Shout out to my boy Famo in the building. Thank you all the comics for coming out. I'm sorry the show ran a little long, but y'all been a great audience. Thank y'all, good night.